Hello, Master 006. We're back for part 19 of I Want to Get Cultured 2. Last time we kicked off the boss rush, I was able to beat the Kermit 2 boss and the Yellow Devil boss from I Don't Want to Be Anything. Both went by in around about the same time, so that was really, really nice. The thought did occur to me, not to think that they're the same difficulty at all. I definitely think the Kermit 2 boss is easier. But the way that fight goes, it probably takes around like 2 to 3 minutes to actually get all the way through that boss on a successful run. Whereas the Yellow Devil one maybe takes about 30 seconds to 45 seconds on a successful run. So, the Yellow Devil one at least is kind of like, you win, or it's over very quickly, because you're going to die. But the Kermit 2 one, it does take a little longer to get through. So, I would definitely still say the Kermit 2 boss is easier than the Yellow Devil one. Anyway, without having spent any massive amount of time actually playing this game, this is sort of take two, because I completely went to the wrong door. I set it up at the end of the last video as well, that I was going to go in the boss on the top left, and I got completely off guard because it wasn't the one I thought it was going to be. Oh, good grief. What I actually wanted to do was go to the one at the bottom right, and that's going to be the one I'm going to do third, because the one at the top left was not the one I thought it was. They were switched around to what I thought they were. Yeah, I definitely want to save the one in the top left for last, and I want to do the one in the bottom right next, because the one in the bottom right is tedium personified. I might not have too much to say on it, and I don't want to do this one last. But yeah, this is take two of this attempted recording, because I pretty much said this same minute-long speech or whatever, introduction, went in the top left door, and it was the wrong boss. So, oh dear. Egg on my face, utterly and entirely. Let's hope it's the right one this time. Yes, cool. I want to be the Justice. That was a fantastic start, by the way. Just beautiful. Don't know whether you guessed from me saying it was going to be Tina personified, but you... Wow, can we at least maybe get past the first, like, apparently not. 10 to 15 seconds, that would be lovely. But, yay, we've got an avoidance. So, without this being the worst thing in the world, and again, avoidance is just not my cup of tea in the slightest. If I can actually get past like the first 15, like 10 seconds or so and actually get into the fight proper, then we might actually be able to do something. Ultimately, a lot of the difficulty in this fight, I think, comes from the very end. So I seem to spend a lot of time at the beginning just having to repeat the first part of the fight a lot. And it just gets incredibly tedious. It's not especially fun. And, ultimately for the end of the boss rush, I didn't want this one to be the last one. So, that being said, I obviously don't want to jinx myself now, but the three avoidances that we've done so far, so Wave, or perhaps not admittedly Wave so much, but Tear It and Meltdown, oh, good grief, they've gone far better than I ever would have thought. So, who knows? Maybe I'll have a good run, an especially good run, and a quick run on I Want to Be the Justice. Not banking on it, by any stretch of the imagination, and I'll start talking about some of the attacks maybe next go. So not banking on doing it this go. If I do, again, by some miracle, I'll re-enter the boss fight and we'll see it again in a bit more detail. Not quite sure what to do here at this point in time, whether to just sort of shut up and concentrate or what. But this is the part of the fight that is just feels very luck based to me. The ones that are spawning in from the corner, the right hand corner over there. I either need a good pattern. Bugger! I think I survived the hardest bit, and then I just got screwed over at the end by, well, again, probably not. I probably just picked a silly spot to try and find the gaps there that just wasn't on clearly, but. That attack from the where the stuff comes in from the right hand side is a right pain in the neck. Anyway, getting way ahead of myself. The one good thing about this, in the sense, is that, well, I guess it depends on your point of view. Actually, from a sense of not being tedious, I guess, or less tedious, this is not the same every time. So again, it's not like the final fight in or the final avoidance in I Want to Find My Destiny, where these come down the same pattern. It is, again, I mean, the same moves will happen. So again, at this point in time, we'll obviously have the projectiles coming down vertically from the ceiling, but they are, not in the same position every time. And after the end of that move, we'll always have this one where wow, are you joking me? I had plenty of time there where I could have moved to the right-hand side further there. The giant wave there was not going to catch up to me, so I don't know what I was playing at there. But anyway, yeah, at this point in time, we'll always have this move. There'll always be a section here now where we'll have two sets of projectiles that fan out, and obviously have to find the gaps in there. And yeah, as I said, once this move is over, we'll have the wave, if you will, of projectiles that we want to move, obviously, to the side and try to avoid. And if you end up getting screwed like that, where I felt compelled like there that I had to jump through and slightly move to the left-hand side to avoid that, I got screwed over by the wave that was coming. Because I wanted to, but obviously I'm positioning myself here in the left-hand, near enough the left-hand corner. I wanted, of course, to move to the right, but yeah, finding that I need to, or I felt compelled there to have to kind of move to the left, at the worst possible time. I'm not sure what the hell even happened there. I presume I just landed on a projectile for some stupid reason. I wasn't paying the slightest bit of attention. I don't quite know what happened there. Regardless, I'm sure it was pretty stupid. Yeah, move to the left, was in the middle of a jump. The wave came along at just the worst possible time. So, yay. And I'm not doing a very good job now on almost anything. As I say, I don't think... I'm trying to think where I would actually place this in terms of, like, the other avoidances we've had. I, to be honest, probably still prefer this over Tear It, but not Meltdown. I mean, obviously, the way this Let's Play is, or the way those avoidances have gone during this Let's Play, tells a slightly different story. But, yeah, all things equal, these are just in the most blur positions ever. All things equal, I'd still say I prefer this over Tear It, but not Meltdown. But chances are, frankly, given the way Tear It and Meltdown went, that this will probably be the one that takes the longest. Anyway, off that last attack there, which is kind of tricky, I find kind of tricky anyway, sort of get a little bit of what I almost dub as I probably die to something here. But this bit feels like a bit more of a breather than the last attack, which is absolutely fine, I'm cool with. Yeah, that bit where the music sort of goes, all the thing goes, blah! After that you get another shockwave, that's really not too bad, doesn't anyone last anywhere near as long as the first one. So, yeah, just, it's not, all the attacks, I mean, they are, of course, slightly varied, slightly different, but in terms of describing them, it's very difficult to sort of pick, to actually, you know, verbalise the differences between them. A lot of them are just kind of like coming down vertically or near vertically from the top of the screen. This is the one I hate, where I kind of feel like I need to be, you know, over in the left-hand corner to be the furthest away from the ones that are coming diagonally from the right. Yeah. Okay. I'm not even going to look at the top of the screen. Okay, I am now. And to be honest, at this point in time, pending a disaster, I didn't think the final thing was all that difficult. So unless I get screwed over, which I'm probably going to now at the end. Yep, because of the falling thing, which I forgot about. Oh my god. Well, I've done it to the point where we actually see the warp there. I didn't survive the damn thing, unfortunately, because I forgot that the bloody cannon thing at the top there fell down. That was awful on my part to have forgotten that that happened. So, yeah, once you get past the bit where the projectiles come in from the right-hand side diagonally down, which I always find difficult, or generally find difficult, I think after that the rest is easier. But, of course, what you need to do is not be, regrettably, in the middle of the screen, or you need to be off much more to one side of the screen than I was there for the very end. Because, the cannon drops, and I was unprepared for it, and I couldn't really get out of the way of it. That was galling. So I would have, again, loved to have had this done that quick. I think that still would have taken, definitely taken longer than Meltdown, but... Again, I don't think it would have taken as long as Tear It or Wave, so Wave, again, would have still been the longest avoidance of this game, which is just incredible to even think, let alone say. I just don't quite know how on earth realistically that would be the case. With that death, I think, unfortunately, unless I do it this go, that will no longer be the case, but, oh well, not that it really matters to anyway, but... Yeah, if I could have come out of this at the end and said, and legitimately said, the wave one was the one that took the longest, just, yeah, wow. I don't know. It feels like at this point in time I'm getting a little bit of lag as well, which, again, I don't want. I'd like to do this completely legit without sort of, you know, suggesting that I've been helped with lag or anything like that, but I feel like I'm detecting some of it, which is not good. But yeah, I'd like to be in the middle for this bit because I feel like... Because I feel like it's going to give me the opportunity to move left and right, as opposed to being more in the corner where I feel like, again, I'm less or more constrained in potentially where I could go. So, yeah, I want to be in the middle for a little bit of that attack, but obviously not at the very end. And that was, I want to say, my downfall, because I literally just completely forgot the cannon fell at the end there. But yeah, if I do pay attention now to the, obviously the... I'll say the health bar, for want of a better phrase, but the timer. Sorry, yeah, that would be a better way of phrasing it, wouldn't it? The timer at the top of the screen, in terms of when the boss is about to end. Yeah, I need to be obviously not in the middle for the end. So unfortunately, that either means I need to pay attention, or just get a feel for maybe even the music, as to when when that point in time is going to come. Or yeah, unfortunately. Somewhat pay a little bit of attention to the top of the screen and the timer, such that I can then move out of the way in the middle of the screen when the cannon falls. But I don't like doing that, I must admit. I'd rather just pay attention to what's going on screen rather than out of the corner of my eye worrying or thinking about looking at the top of the screen. But yeah, other than obviously a few like clumsy or what feel like kind of silly deaths at the beginning, It's the sort of the end of this, which is fine. I have no complaints about, you know, the difficult bit of this avoidance being at the end. I feel like, you know, from a scaled difficulty point of view, that's absolutely fine. But unfortunately, it is annoying that the most difficult bits are probably, you know, right. Oh, what? It lagged! It lagged, and I moved early into a bloody projectile. No! Oh god, at least I think that's what happened. Good grief! But, obviously, unfortunately, with all the, or 90% of the most difficult bits coming at the beginning, this is exactly what I was saying with it being teed and personified. I mean, the beginning bit and everything up to that point is clearly not a gimme, clearly, to the point where I just can completely zone out or tune out or whatever, so I do have to give this my utmost care and attention all the time. But yeah, it isn't half tedious when most of the difficulty is at the bloody end of the thing, and you feel like that's not good at all. I don't know what the hell I was even thinking there. Not good at all when most of the difficulty is at the very end, and without it being a walk in the park to get to that point, you're dealing with, you know, comparatively much easier stuff at the beginning that you have to keep doing over and over and over again. And that's where, of course, the tedium comes in. So I feel like, oh my god, again, just the timing on that. I don't know whether my strategy there clearly probably isn't very good, but the way those projectiles came down, I felt again like I had to go to the left, I had to sort of jump or something to try and find a gap, and just the worst timing in the world. I think I definitely won't try and jump now, because I think at least that's not really helping. Because at least if I'm still moving to the left-hand side, I can probably still backtrack to the right and get out of it. So we'll try and dodge this without jumping. No, we won't, because we'll get hit to the final little bit just before that happens. Although, frankly, I feel like I did get somewhat screwed over there with just where I have to be positioned where those projectiles fell. Again, I'm not saying I shouldn't have avoided that, but again, you could have been far nicer and just not dropped two projectiles right there and then in such close proximity. There, that one looked ridiculous, frankly. The bit on the, where I was on the left-hand side there, frankly, just looked like there was no room whatsoever anywhere. Again, that's not to say that was completely the case, but that didn't look very nice. And again, I've come now after I've said, oh, the beginning bit is easier. Yeah, again, not easy, easier. And, having all the troubles now at the beginning bit. So, yay, wonderful. That does not look very nice. Okay, a little tiny hop there, it's fine. I mean, you didn't shoot those out in a very very nice either. Again, they could have been miles away from me, you know, so that I don't have to. Wasn't worried at all about that. But no, I was panicking there. And at this point in time, again, I'm just now there's not really much else to say on this. I will probably give it maybe one more decent go, and then frankly, I'm just going to cut it because, as I say, it's very. Are you kidding me? What? There's not much exact variety in the attacks. There's very little to talk about in terms of these attacks. Like again, this one's vertical. I mean, at some point in time, there'll be a spread shot with two attack with that comes out twice that we have to avoid, and then this will continue vertically, and there'll be two more, and then we'll have the wave, blah, blah, blah. But I mean, yeah, it's just ultimately an avoidance where you're dodging a rain of projectiles from the sky. So, there isn't enough, I believe, sufficient variety, really, in these types of attacks to be able to, you know, describe them, or describe, you know, really good differences between them. So, yeah. But yeah, honestly, the middle third of this fight feels like a breather compared to the first third. Although the first third isn't as difficult as the last third. But, the middle third here feels like the real breather. Which, again, isn't so bad, perhaps. But, yeah, if anything, it's this bit that sort of feels like... Again, I'm going to completely jinx myself. But this is the bit that feels like the tedious bit. Because this bit just feels so much easier than the rest of the fight. Or the rest of the avoidance, sorry. I don't really call it a fight. Probably getting a bit above and beyond. I didn't like that pattern at all, very... by the way. Or this. Don't like that. Okay. Right. Be nice, please. Okay, I'm looking at the top and I can see the timer. So, just, let it kind of run down. Try not to move to a corner too soon. And get screwed over like that. Fan-flipping-tastic, yeah. We'll cut that. I'm sufficiently pissed off at that now that, nothing else to say on it. This is possibly the one that's going to take the longest then, and, I'm not too surprised about that, frankly. I thought the Yellow Devil one is very hit and miss. It could go either way, but, this is just tedious. This is not especially fun. Not the type of bosses I like to do, like doing whatsoever. And, fine. We'll cut to the successful run, and I'll obviously let you know how long it took. Okay, another 6 minutes or so. Yeah, from cutting to actually pulling that off. So I want to say about 20 minutes total with however long an introduction that was. So again, that actually wasn't that bad. If that was going to go on for ages, I had this whole thing planned where I was going to say the avoidance gods were with me on, well, let's really wave out of it, but the avoidance gods were with me for tearing and meltdown, but they weren't with me for justice. But again, you know what, 20 minutes, I'll take that, frankly. But yeah, definitely didn't want to, like I say, there was a clear rhyme and a reason behind the order in which I wanted to do these bosses. I wanted to do the easiest, or what I thought was going to be the easiest one first, just to kind of get into it. But Yellow Devil and the Yellow Devil item fight from I didn't want to be anything, and that Justice Avoidance were definitely going to be the second and third ones, because I didn't want to start with either of them, and I didn't want to end with either of them. So, definite order to what I wanted to do. Okay, anyway, we have three of the four done, so let's take on the last one, which is Metamorphosis. So, please don't start with the lag and everything like that. I do want to just quickly address before we get into this too much, was that I'm sure the music does sync up very slightly differently in that Justice fight, so I think again, regrettably, for whatever reason, there was a little bit of lag and slowdown in that fight, not to the point where I still think it made it ridiculously easy or anything like that, but I swear that the music sort of wasn't quite syncing up where, at certain points in time, with an attack I thought was coming. It sort of seemed like it could be even just half a second or a second out, but anyway. Here we are in the last one, Metamorphosis. We have an infinite jump, or they say you can infinity jump, which is kind of not really proper English. this one is the second of the two. Obviously, the avoidance one was not really going to be able to using the, nowhere I could be able to use the charge shot ability. This Metamorphosis one, absolutely, because yet again, it's one of those ones, like the Yellow Devil fight, that has invincibility frames. This is lagging ridiculously. I apologise for this. I feel like, this is just almost, I don't want to say it's just completely trivialising this, this fight, or certainly not the Justice Avoidance, but I feel like I'm sort of cheesing a lot of these fights, or cheesing a lot of what's going on in the game with this lag or slowdown, because it's just it is making things easier. I can't deny. At times, at very specific times, it is screwing me over, but most of the time, it's certainly helping. But anyway, we have this character over here, and for the first attack, we got this. For goodness sake, apologies, we're just going to have to live with this slowdown. It's not nice. I don't like it at all, but can't do anything about it. Aggressively. The first attack is pretty straightforward. Most of these attacks, to be honest, are fairly straightforward. I'll talk about maybe the first one when we get back to it. The second one sends out these red and blue projectiles, and you obviously just want to find the gaps when they go translucent. That wasn't enough to kill it. Okay, or beat that phase. They come out in a sort of circling pattern, and as I say, you just want to basically want to try and jump and not just land on projectiles straight away. Anyway, back to this one. Yeah, this one is sort of easy once you get into a rhythm. But if you lose your rhythm on this one, this one can be kind of tricky just to find the gaps in these arty projectiles. So it shouldn't be anything to complain about per se. But it can be a little tricky. As I say, this one just find the gaps in these circles and when the things go translucent and just sort of make your way. Inwards when that happens. I'm going to die here. Oh, no, I'm not going to die there. Okay. The charge shot here is, again, like with I don't want to be anything, an absolute godsend. The third one feels like it's just a kind of like projectiles out in a spread shot pattern, so just do your best to avoid those. This one is a red and blue fruit pattern one, so just try and find the gaps as best you can. When they go translucent and there's a bit of a sort of a phase shift or whatever, the fruit sort of changes, switches up its position. And you want to try and find the gaps as best you can there. Here we have another one that's very similar, sort of the third attack, although these ones sort of tend to come out a little faster, I find. We have this attack, which is probably the one I'm dreading the most, just because it can be quite difficult to avoid some of these projectiles. But what you want to try and do is just try and go in a kind of a circling pattern. I feel like the way I've done it there is pretty good, to be honest. I think that's it now. We're done with the attacks. So I think this is no, it's not the final thing. No, it's not the final thing whatsoever. But yeah, after that point in time, we get this little lovely section. So it's a mirror kid kind of thing. The important thing is to pay attention to the kid on the right hand side of the screen and avoid the fruit. Obviously, you don't want the one on the left hand side. You can see what happens if the kid on the left hand side does touch fruit. He does send out these particles across to the other side, and you obviously want to avoid those. But yeah, at a certain point in time, it's going to be very difficult to actually avoid those in their entirety anyway. So just put a premium on the kid on the left hand side of the screen. Staying away from the fruit. And that brings us to the final phase, where she bobs. Oh, I'm going to... Oh, I survived that. That was awesome. But I didn't survive that. Crap. that final phase, you'd think... Or maybe you wouldn't. I don't know. You'd think that sort of, like, multiple version of the kid there could cause a bit of alarm in terms of thinking, like, you know, where you need to be positioned on screen. But to be honest, I don't get distracted whatsoever by the different version of the kids there. It's just the projectiles can actually be quite difficult to avoid. Because they do, like, kind of, the red and blue ones do kind of close in on you. So, I wouldn't put that death down at all, frankly, to the, just to the multiple versions of the kid or me getting confused by where a safe spot was and where it wouldn't be. That was more just due to the actual inherent difficulty of the red and blue projectiles kind of being in my way. So yeah, so the charge shot just makes this so much easier. To be honest, that last attack... Oh my god, I didn't jump for some stupid reason. I have absolutely no idea why. Without the charge shot, you can imagine that this fight just gets dragged on considerably more. Being able to do double damage, or I don't even know if it is exactly double damage or what, but being able to do certainly more damage each time I can shoot. And again, because of the invincibility frames, it's not like I'm wasting any additional time. What? I must have shot her here, I think, during when she was already, when there was invincibility frames, and that didn't count, because that phase went on a lot longer than I was expecting it to. The invincibility frames, can I give me a pattern that allow me to actually get down and shoot you? That would be lovely. But yeah, with the invincibility frames, again, prime target for the charge shot, because shooting away manically, like, for example, I would do on the Kermit boss, not going to get me anywhere. So I can use the invincibility frames to recharge my shot, shoot it the wrong way, and deal more damage than I otherwise would do. Cool. Right, it was this one I died to really stupidly last time, wasn't it? I just didn't jump for some stupid reason. Yeah, I don't quite know what I was doing, why I didn't, What? I swear I shot at the wall there. That actually killed her? I don't quite know what happened there. No, what the hell did I do there? I think I missed a shot on her. I didn't charge shot there and just shot her straight at the beginning. I mean, that's no excuse for dying like that. But, I don't know what I was doing there. But, oh my god, that last go where I got to the circling one. As I said before, I do actually find that one quite tricky. Finding the gaps with those four fruit patterns, the projectile patterns from the four different colours, kind of awkward. You don't seem to get a lot of room to dodge a lot of that, so... that can be kind of tricky. I don't know what I'm doing here with just not hitting her or whatever. I mean, again, this one's probably about the easiest phase, easiest attack of the entire lot, to be honest. As long as you keep finding the safe spots in the circles, you shouldn't have any problem with that attack at all. I keep getting sort of like here stuffed at the top where I can't like actually get down to hit her, so that's kind of annoying. Is the music gone, or was it just probably coming to the end of its loop? Okay, I was a bit surprised there that there wasn't any music, or it was taking a long time to get back in. Okay, that has me incredibly nervous. Oh, that wasn't the last hit, did it? Yeah, anyway, I'm still surprised by that one where I swear I shot backwards at the wall. And somehow, I know what happened, apart from a stupid clumsy death there. I know what happened. I did the charge shot at the wall, But I released a regular shot. Do you automatically release a regular shot at the same time you do a charge shot? The charge shot went in the wall. But the regular shot went in the proper direction, to the left. So that must have hit her, and that must have been the final hit. So I was, really confused by that. Not to say that I'm sort of calling out the justice one on it being tedious. That isn't to say this one isn't either, just because it does go on for quite a while. You end up sort of getting into a rut on some of these phases. Almost none at the moment for me, because I haven't really got anyone other than the circling one at the moment I feel especially confident on. I'm not going to die on, but certain phases are definitely easier than others, and regrettably, I'd say the two hardest ones are two of the last three, not the one where we've got the Mirror Kid and playing around with that. I actually think that one's, again, not easy, but I think that's easier than the four circling fruit one and also the last attack. But you do just get into a little bit of tedium with this. I say not so much with the avoid, or not as much as I do with the justice one, but still. Yeah, there are lots of different ways you could do this in terms of finding the gaps with the circle. So I tend to like to go up there. I've got through. Lovely. I like to just tend to go up just to the right and then down and then through to the left. But multiple different ways you could do that. So yeah, thankfully this bit only goes on for 30 seconds or so. But again, it's who knows? I'll probably come a cropper now. But put a premium on. I mean, pay attention to the left hand side where you can, but put a premium on focusing much of your attention on the right hand. So I mean, again, at this after 10, when it goes down to 10 seconds, it sort of becomes a bit like you're almost barely, you're going to do incredibly well to not hit any of the fruit on the left hand side. So yeah, put a premium on just focusing on the real kid on the right hand side. And avoid the fruit as best as possible. It tends to probably be the blue. What? Where was I? I didn't actually even. Seriously, I cannot even describe that failure. I couldn't even actually see where I was on screen. I literally have absolutely no idea why I hit, where I was, or anything. I can't even describe that. I literally cannot describe what happened there or anything. I just completely couldn't see where I was. I have honestly got no idea what happened there. None at all. Anyway, the final phase for me, I'd say, is probably the most difficult one. And again, I can't really complain about that being the case, to be honest. It's annoying that the final thing is the most difficult. As I say, it's nothing to do with the multiple versions of the kid or anything like that. It's simply to do with the just inherent difficulty of avoiding the projectiles, mainly the blue ones, because the red ones sort of come out a bit slower, but the blue ones are much quicker. I don't want to say they home in on you or anything like that, because I don't think that's the case, but if I'm going to die to anything, that was just awful. I have no words for that one. If I'm going to die to anything, it's likely to be all that. Yeah, I guess I could obviously hit a red one while in the course of and trying to dodge a blue one, but it will be the blue ones that sort of. Yeah, in the course of dodging a blue one that makes me career into a red one. So, it's the blue ones that cause the problems on the final phase. The red ones, not so much, although obviously you have to pay attention to them. And now I'm just not really doing anything. Not really doing anything at all. I was kind of. I mean, it feels bad to say, like, I feel like I'm doing a bad job on this boss rush. I've done, I did. It feels like I did the, Kermit 2 and the Yellow Devil in 15 minutes. Justice Avoidance in like 20 minutes, around those times. This has been going, I want to say, probably about 15 minutes-ish by now. So it's not like these are taking, again, like I should be expected to somehow beat these that quickly, but I don't know. I don't know. None of them feel like they've gone that well. I'm very acutely aware of the obvious irritation, which you've no doubt detected as well, in my voice, and particularly the Yellow Devil fight, and also the Justice avoidance. I'm trying not to get annoyed so much on this one. This one is definitely more fun than the those ones, but again, it's one of those ones, again, that just can be kind of tedious, can be long and drawn out, and does take an awful bloody long time to complete. As I said, so does the Justice one, admittedly, and the Kermit one, but, how quick was that done? the Yellow Devil one is over quick, but the other three do take a long time to beat. So, tedium sets in, fatigue sets in, and you just feel like you're doing the same thing over and over again with not much reward. I'm dead. Oh my god. Well, I should have probably been dead there because I hung about way too long, and that was really irritating. You have to do that cycle it feels like, at least with the charge shots, unless I'm just not doing it quick enough. It feels like you have to go through the cycle twice, which is kind of irritating. I'd love to have to only do it once, or at least not do the bit where I have to go back to the left for the second time. I think I probably could just about squeeze that, getting that in before I have to go back to the left for the second time, but it feels kind of tight. What? Again, how is this one... How is that phase, again, taken so long that time? I feel like there's something to the health bar sort of maintaining a little bit of the previous fight, so I guess if you sort of... I don't know, I might be talking complete nonsense here, but... So like, for instance, I killed that one with a charge shot. If I killed it with a regular shot and only got it down to, like, the last hit of that phase, I can't believe I survived. Well, I was about to say I can't believe I survived that, but then I didn't. The point I'm trying to make, for example, is let's, for argument, say, a charge shot does 2 damage and the regular buster shot, the regular sort of buster shot, like a Mega Man playing Mega Man here, the regular shot does 1 damage. If, let's just for argument's sake, say it's got 2 phases, each of 20 HP each of 10. So if I get you down to 11 and then I hit with a regular shot, then I'm going to get you down to 10 and the second phase is going to have 10 HP. Whereas if I hit with a charge shot and you're at 11 and it does double damage, then the second phase doesn't start until it's at 9 HP. So I don't know if there is anything in that or whether they all just have a complete set amount of health each time, but it doesn't half feel like sometimes these phases are going by. Again, maybe it's just because I'm shooting too early before the invincibility frames have gone away or something, so that a shot's not counting, but yeah, some of these phases feel like they're going by very quick sometimes, and other times it feels like they're taking ages. I can't quite, other than missing shots or just being too quick with shots, like that again, for example. That one I only had to dodge one wave of those circling things, whereas before I felt like it was about 3 sometimes even, so yeah. It was lucky that phase ended when it did there, because I was about to land right on a projectile. So, all I can say was that was excellent timing. I should probably more accurately say that was lucky timing rather than anything excellent on my part. Yes, good. I sort of took a liberty there. I was sort of recognised, given the amount of hits I thought I'd already got on there, that was going to be the kill shot for that phase. So, thankfully that was the case. So yeah, okay, I probably just shut up and concentrate on this one. Yeah, this isn't the problem, it's getting over back to the left here. I went a little bit earlier there, I don't know whether that made any difference, but... Yeah, okay, fine, that went much better. We'll get rid of the charge shot now, because I don't want to be charging for this bit. To be honest, this is probably going to be the final go again, before cutting if I don't do it this go, because, we've kind of gone on for probably about 20 minutes or so. Are you joking me? That was absolutely awful. What a way to have the final go before the cut. So, yay, I've needed to... No, I haven't. I didn't need to cut the devil boss on another one. But, these two bosses I've needed to cut because, as I say, ran out of things to say. I'm hoping it hasn't come across as being particularly irritated on this one, although I'm getting there, because even then they're not taking that long. As I say, you know, again, 20 minutes or so, but I mean, I don't want to waste your time just, you know, keep showing these off, keep doing these over and over again with nothing to say, other than a general rant about how pathetic I feel I'm doing at the moment. But they haven't gone so terribly bad, to be honest. But bosses, the third and the fourth ones have unfortunately both required cuts because run out of things to say. And they take a bloody long time. Okay. 12 minutes or so. Not too bad, about maybe half an hour then in total. But yeah, we get some prizes and such. We're doing so, what a rush. Clearly optional boss rush. So, we'll open up our treasure chest. We get dressed up in a little bit of a camellia costume while we're here. So I guess actually let's tackle one more achievement by actually selecting all the camellia stuff. So as you can see here, standard kid. A lot. I'm not going to be getting much of the other ones, but yeah, the face scraper. So we've got camellia 3. I'm hoping I'm going to do this correctly. I'm not sure whether it matters whether it's K2 or K3. Let's put that on K2. And I think this one needs to be... What? It's locked? Really? Okay, maybe I'm not going to be able to get the, what? The achievement. What? There is an achievement. Maybe I haven't got it yet. Maybe I need to have, completed the main game or something? Yeah, these are all locked. I can't do anything with the special effects at the moment. Okay, never mind me. I actually can't do what I thought I could. Maybe that's obviously, so we'll put that back to normal culture 2 spikes and standard kid, standard kid for that, just because, frankly. But yeah, okay, I'm getting ahead of myself. There must be something that I get for later in the game, or something that allows me to do what I want to do. Basically, I need to put all the camellia stuff on, and I get an achievement for decking out in the camellia style stuff. So yeah, but obviously, apparently, I can't do that yet. Anyway, I'm hoping we'll get that sorted by the end of this Let's Play. But yeah, obviously, misremembered that I can't do that yet. Anyway, yeah, that is that, and I'm not going to enter stage 6 yet. I'm going to leave it behind that door, and we'll see what all that is about later. But yeah, I managed to get through the boss rush, not too bad. Apologies if it's felt like these last two videos in particular I've been quite irritable. There's a bit more annoyance in my voice. I can definitely tell that myself. What can I say? I'm not a massive fan of that boss rush. Just unfortunately, I found that a lot of the fights end up being. I mean, none of that, I don't think anyone there took... I think maybe that was the longest one, that Metamorphosis one, and I want to say that took half an hour in, maybe in total. So if that's the longest one, then, I mean, yeah, I reckon it was about 15 minutes, 20 minutes for... 20 or so minutes for Justice, 15 minutes each for Kermit and the Yellow Devil, and then half an hour for that. So in total, what are we looking at? An hour and 20 for all those? I hope I've got my numbers correct there. Yeah, I think, yeah. Yeah, 30, 20, 15, and 15. Yeah, that should be an hour and 20. So, again, if you'd offered me that, frankly, before I went into the boss rush, I probably would have bitten your hand off to say, okay, fine, going to deal with four potentially irritating bosses that could go on for ages, could get dragged out, could be rather tedious. You're going to beat those in an hour and 20 or under an hour and a half? I probably would have snapped your hand off. But, again, for whatever reason, while I was doing the commentary for whatever, it just felt like, ugh. Things were just annoying me. It felt rather tedious, particularly those last two. Unfortunately, I wasn't expecting the Metamorphosis one to feel quite as tedious. I mean, it didn't feel as tedious as the Justice one, let's put it that way. And ultimately, the Yellow Devil was probably quite kind at the end of the day, although it didn't still feel like that when I was playing it through. But, I guess I apologize if it felt more frustrating there. But, yeah, ultimately, I don't hate the thing. Don't hate the fact the boss rush is there. It can be a nice little distraction, but, nah. Not my cup of tea, really. But anyway, as I said, yeah, they're all done. The longest one was half an hour, so I don't feel like I can complain too much about it. So, yay. With that out of the way, we can scoot back to the main game. So, as I say, we've got all the little bits and pieces that I feasibly could do at this point in time out of the way. So, yeah, we've got stage 6 to come next time. That's not the entirety of stage 6. I mean, that will probably be spread over 4 or 5 videos. We'll see what's going on with stage 6, and I'll explain how that's all going to work. Probably again with pausing after I've cleared one stage to see how long the next one takes. So the next few videos might be less of a defined like start or end that I've got in mind when I'm actually recording. But anyway, I'll explain how that's all going to work next time. But yeah, what can I say? Boss rush out of the way, we can get back to the main game, and hopefully I'll feel less frustrated on stage 6. Or I wouldn't bank on it. There are a few sections of Stage 6 that could royally piss me off. Hopefully that won't happen, though. And anyway, tune in next time to see how Stage 6 goes. Until then, cheerio.